Everybody has money. You know, when you start off as an entrepreneur, you are bootstrapping your face off. You've got to do all the things. You've got to fill all the roles. You've got to, you know, live on ramen noodles if you need to. You've got to go to your parents' basement. I mean, you've got to be willing to do what it takes to give your business the longevity, the runway that it's going to take to get to profitability, which is so, so hard. So if you start bringing people on your team before you even know what you're doing, you're just going to be spending money that you don't have. You're going to be decreasing your runway. And then entrepreneurs don't run out necessarily of money or ideas. They just run out of time. Like their runway just ended and that's it. Like they're done. And so you as an entrepreneur need to say, okay, I need to master these things, chapter 1 through 14, steps 1 through 14, so I know how to do these things so that when I do end up building that team, hopefully, number one, I've got some revenue coming in at this point because I followed those first 14 steps. But number two, I know exactly how to train them. I know exactly what I want them to do because you're not going to be bringing in these, you know, experts from, you know, X, Y, and Z places from Google and Amazon and Apple. Because you can't pay them hundreds of thousands of dollars a year. You're going to be bringing on virtual assistants. You're paying a few hundred dollars a month, which is exactly what I did. And they came with a desire to work, but no skills, no knowledge. I had to give them that knowledge, give them those skills. And that only came by me doing the thing prior to building that team. So I see people building teams way too early. And I think that's a big mistake most of the time.